This close from being in the promised land. Oh my gosh, it would have been so great. Oh, if Jimmy, I'm gonna get to all that later. How's everyone doing? I hope you're all having a positive day. Hope you had a great Memorial Day yesterday. I kind of did. It was a little bit rainy, a little chaotic with the weather. You know, the usual stuff. So obviously now you know the title. You know, this Miami Heat season is officially done. I know I'm making this video late, but I just needed time to, you know, mourn the season, you know, just to grasp what just really happened out there. Well, here we are. I've calmed down a little bit. Not really, but I'm still, that loss is living rent-free in my head still to this day. I think I need some help for that. Anyway, but yeah, it's officially done. The Celtics are in the finals. And they're gonna face the Golden State Warriors, and I hate to say that. Oh, that pains me to say that. And Lord knows, I despise, like, I really, really despise the Celtics with all my heart. But it is what it is. We can't change that. So obviously, you know, I know everyone is disappointed. Even me, I was disappointed. I was mad. Here's the thing. I get passionately mad when things don't go right. Such as a turnover, even like the stupidest little things. I'm like just going off, like very silently. I don't scream. I just go silently. Yeah. You idiot. What are you doing? Oh yeah. Trust me. I'm bad if you ever see me out there. It is what it is. You know, Boston just killed us in the paint. Just killed us everywhere. They just had more weapons and they were just more talented. And the thing that's such a big difference between us and them is that they're younger, we're old. I know people love to, you know, dogpile on Bam from being, you know, way too soft out there at times, which I get it. You know, don't get me wrong. Bam is my favorite player on the team. What I've been seeing in this playoff series is disgusting. It is very, very disgusting. Sure, there were a couple of games where he showed out, you know, like in game 3, and of course the last game he had 25 points, but it's like, it's not enough. And I keep saying this time and time and time again before we even began the playoffs or even after the Atlanta series. Bam needs to help this team. He needs to score more than 15 points. And if not, you're going to lose the game. You're going to lose the series. Look what happened. I'm not saying that's all on Bam, but that's one of the reasons why we failed. And obviously, you know, people say Kyle Lowry was just a poor offseason move, but I kind of disagree with that. I mean, sure, we can't really expect Kyle, who's, 38 or 37? Like, he's getting up there in age. But we can't really expect him to do all that. I mean, I know he's a great floor general. That's what we've been asking for since Tim Hardaway. You know, there's at times where he can get people in comfortable spots. Obviously, it didn't happen. You know, you can tell that hamstring was sort of, like, still killing him in the side. It's been a mess. And, you know, that's kind of like the whole debacle that we've always been injured. It's always injuries that kill us that almost get us close to that promised land. Just like when we faced the Lakers in the bubble, Bam and Goran Dragic went out. Sure, they came back, but they weren't the same when they came back. And look what happened. But it is what it is. But I gotta give the biggest credit to Jimmy Butler. Jimmy Bucket Butler, man. Like, you can tell in the future, this is going off there in the rafters. I can't wait for it to go. That'll be the day, huh? Number 22, going off to the rafters of the American Airlines Arena. I know it's FTX. I am not calling it that. I don't even get that name. But that's a whole other issue. Yeah, I'm calling it AAA. Why not? Because I can. I grew up with it. If you got a problem, deal with it. Even though the season's over, you know, you still... Sure, like I said, most of us are disappointed, but you still have to feel a sense of pride that, okay, you know, we did what we did. You know, we got to the Eastern Conference Finals. Sure, the outcome isn't pretty, but at least now we know how to get back there and possibly get stronger next year. And that's why, Pat, has to do, like, you can tell that Pat and Zoe are going to be busy this offseason. They're going to try to make a lot of moves. Like, some of the players that we have might not be back here. Like, Dwayne Dedman, bye-bye. I can see him going off because you'd barely played him in the last few games. Who else? I mean, Markieff Morris, he's gone too. Those are pretty much the only two players that I know. People say Kyle Lowry might not be here. I disagree with that. We're going to give him another chance. It is what it is. So, I mean, some of the undrafted players I can see leaving. Maybe Yurtseven. I mean, if we wanted to develop him and try to see what he can do, maybe not. I don't know. Since we do have a draft pick this year, unlike the rest of the previous years, which was boring, I would say, and I saw this on Five Reasons when they interviewed Norris Call, and he even said this too, and I kind of agree with him. I think they need to go out and draft a 3-and-D player. They need to draft a wing player that can help in the ISO, that can help with scoring, and can be, you know, that can have a shot creator that can, you know, sort of help this team. Sure, Tyler's that, but, you know, he doesn't really have that it factor yet. You know, he's still pretty young. But yeah, I don't want to draft a center in the draft. I don't want to do that. I want to go in the offseason and, you know, sign an experienced center just to help Bam. And I keep saying this from day in and day out, ever since Bam got drafted here, put him at the forward position. Put him at the power forward where he's meant to play. Sign a center, move him to the five. You got to help Bam. Like, don't get me wrong, Bam's a great defender. But you can see at times that he's just too undersized for his size. When he goes up against these bigs, you know, like Robert Williams, who's about the same size as him, even Brook Lopez or the Giannises or whatever players you want to go up against, you gotta put him at four. I'm sorry, like, I know a lot of you don't want to hear that, but for me, put him at the four, please. I don't want to see him in the center ever again. I mean, he could. I know he likes to switch a lot. That's okay. Like, if he wants to switch the center to the five during the game, I'm cool with that. But stop putting him as your main center. Even when it comes to the big games, you can't do that. I know that there are a couple players or some fans want to trade Hero away. I'm like, nah. The man won sixth and the man of the year. They're probably going to move him to starter next year. I mean, it's most likely going to happen. Tyler made a lot of noise during this regular season. Sure, he didn't do anything in the playoffs, but he made a lot of noise, and, you know, knowing Pat, he's like, okay, boy, you're going to come, well, not Pat, Spo, really, which I got to get credit to. You know, Spo, time and again, has proven me wrong and has proven me like an idiot, and I'm glad he's doing that. Sure, he didn't finish the season on a good note, well, kind of, pretty much did, but Spo, in my opinion, he's the real coach of the year, not Monty Williams. I mean, yeah, look, Monty Williams, what he did with the Suns is incredible, and I agree with that. Maybe, in my opinion, he should have won last year. My preference. But this year, it should have gone to Spo. I mean, not just a Heat fan, but just in general. Well, it is kind of a Heat fan thing. But yeah, people, you know, keep saying, like, ever since LeBron left, like, oh, Spo's not great. Like, oh, Spo can't coach a team. And then 2016, 2017 happened. We went on that 13-game winning streak, and that was the moment that kind of made me respect Spo as a coach, finally. No all-stars, no great role players, or a lot of undrafted players and a lot of players that no one wants anymore, and he turned them into something. Sure, they didn't finish the playoffs, but they didn't go into the playoffs, but he still turned them into something and went on that historic 13-game winning streak. Like, holy cow. How many coaches can do that to a team like that? Huh? I think that's one of my favorite teams of all time. Or one of them. Well, it's one of them. But, yeah. I'm done with this season. You know, Boston can go screw themselves, really. Because I just don't. I don't. But I'm not going to really watch the NBA Finals. I'm just not interested. I just can't. Like, I just can't watch it without knowing that should have been our rightful place in that position, not them. Like, who even predicted the Celtics to come out? Because I remember they started, like, pretty bad early in the season, and then they just went explosive, you know? Like, where the hell did these guys even come from? Shout out to Boston for making it. Even, like I said, I'm not gonna watch the NBA Finals, but I'm still rooting for the Warriors, because Like I said, I do not like Boston. I do not like the Celtics one bit. I mean, I've been to the city of Boston. It's nice. A little cold, but nice. But the Celtics, no. No. You get no support from me. Mm-mm. Sorry. I can expect a lot of these, some of these other undrafted gems to stay in the team next year. Like Gabe Vincent, Max Strus, holy crap. Did they prove us wrong this year? Especially Gabe. Like, he's really turned himself into something. You can tell he's like really learned from Avery Bradley when he was here last year. Like, he's picked up those traits and he did something with them. Wow, Gabe Vincent is going to be something. I hope. I mean, maybe not for the whole future, but I think he'll take another leap next year, in my opinion. And same thing with Max Strus. Like, wow! I knew there was something interesting in this guy when we signed him last year as an undrafted gem, as an undrafted player. When I saw him in the preseason last year, I'm like, oh, I can see him being around. Same with Gabe, same with Duncan, same with UD, same with Dedman. Well, those came in later. I'm like, all right, okay. I like what you're doing. Especially what he did in this year's summer league. When he made that game-winning three against the Grizzlies. I'm like, oh, I think he's earned a spot on this roster. I would not be surprised if he started, well, which he did. Well, I didn't really think that, no. What am I talking about? But Max Strus, wow, you are something. I'm glad we have you. I can't wait to see what you do next year. And I know a lot of people are mad about the missed three, that three he didn't make because his foot was out of bounds. I mean, here's the thing. I kind of disagree with that. I think that was the right call. Yeah, I might be unbiased, but he did kind of, the knee kind of did touch the out of bounds line. That's just the way I look at it. I probably just anger a lot of people right now, but that's cool. That's kind of what I do here, right? That's pretty much it. I just wanted to get that off my chest. Because this is kind of like therapy for me. You know, just explaining my emotional thoughts about this whole ordeal that's been going on. I know it's been a couple of days, but I just wanted to get this off. I just wanted to get this thing out. I'm tired. I'm ready to move on. The Celtics are a horrible team. I don't think they'll win the NBA champion. And yes, I'm a Heat fan. I will talk crap about them for the rest of the time. But that's me. But good luck to the both teams this Thursday. I believe it's when it starts. Good luck to them to the finals. I won't be watching, but I'll still be supporting Steph and the Warriors. Because I like that team more than the Boston Celtics. I'm not switching teams. I just need, and I don't care if this is not me supporting the Warriors for getting their another champion. This is just me for an act as a revenge, and it's for them to, you know, for the Warriors to avenge our loss, basically. All right, guys. Well, let's go Heat, and let's hope we get stronger next year. Next year, it's either championship or bust. Got to do something about that. We got to. And Bam, get aggressive. That's all I got to say.